نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمين المتين الكريم ونحن ولا ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الله تبارك وتعالى Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullaha wa kunu ma'as sadiqeen. O you who believe, fear Allah and be with the truthful. In every corner of the world, Hazrat Ghawthul Azam Dastagir, Abu Muhammad Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani al-Baghdadi's urs is being celebrated. He was born on 470 Hijri during the reign of Seljuqi Empire. And he left this world on 561 Hijri on 11th of Rabiul Thani in Baghdad. Hazrat Ghawthul Azam Dastagir Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala and says that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, Kun fayakun, be and it is. That whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command to happen, it will happen. When you obey Him, whenever you will say, it will happen. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed this blessing on most of His prophets, saints and special servants. And indeed, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has blessed Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani with this power. First of all, Hazrat Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani was not only Ghawthul Azam in Vilayat, in fact, he was also the greatest Imam in knowledge. He was Imam-e-Azam in knowledge. He was Imam-e-Akbar in knowledge. He was an extremely talented Mufassir. He was an extremely talented Imam in Tafsir. He was an extremely talented Imam in Hadith, in Imam in Fiqh. And miracles were one of his habits. And Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani used to teach around 13 sciences every day. Such a great scholar of Shariat and Tariqat he was. And every year, around 3,000 students used to graduate from his madrasa. I want to draw people's attention to things that are not often told. His miracles are not one but thousands. So this is the reason I said his miracles were his habits. So every year, 3,000 students would graduate from his madrasas. First 10 years when Sultan Salahuddin Ayyubi conquered Jerusalem, most of the soldiers in his army were the students of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala. Second, the chief advisor of Sultan Salahuddin Ayyubi in this victory was Imam Ibn Qudama Maqdisi al-Hambali. He was one of the disciple and Khalifa of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, who has acquired knowledge directly from Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala. Now look at this golden chapter, this beautiful chapter in history which has been written by Sayyid Sultan Salahuddin Ayyubi. This golden chapter which had been written in Islamic history had the blessing of none other than Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala. Allah Akbar. Allama Ibn Taymiyyah writes in his book Al-Istiqama, he writes the miracle of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. And the narrator is Hazrat Sheikh Sohawardi radiallahu ta'ala. He states that when I had studied the books, I intended to study ilm kalam. But I was confused about which book shall I study. Shall I read Imam al-Harmain al-Juwaini's book al-Irshad? Or shall I study Imam Sharastani's book Bihayatul Aqdam? So my Sheikh Hazrat Abu Najib Sohawardi brought me before Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala. So I thought that when the namaz will get over and the gathering will start, then I will ask Hazrat Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani and do whatever he says. So I went with this idea. The prayers had not been offered yet and there was no gathering. The thought was in my heart. And suddenly Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani turned towards me and said, O Umar, these books will not work in the grave. فَرَجِعَتُ عَنْ ذَلِكَ I understood that Hazrat Ghawthul Azam had discovered and guided me knowing the condition of my heart. So I gave up the idea of my heart. Allahu Akbar. This is the word of Allama Ibn Taymiyyah in his book, Inna Sheikha Kashafahu Bima Kana Fi Qalbihi. That Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala discovered what was in his heart. This was the status of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. Imam Ibn Hajar Asqalani says that 70,000 people used to gather in the majlis, in the programs of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala. Imam Ibn Hajar Asqalani said that His voice reached to every single person in the pogrom, and that too the same voice was heard to the people in the last row as compared to the people in the first row as well. Imam Ibn al-Jawzi, who was a great muhaddis, he arrived at Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani's pogrom, and Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani recited a verse of the Holy Quran and then explained its interpretation, its tafsir. So Imam Ibn al-Jawzi, who was accompanied by another Imam, that Imam asked Ibn al-Jawzi, did he knew this interpretation? He said, yes, I knew this interpretation. Then Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani narrated the second interpretation. Then the another Imam asked again, did he knew this interpretation? Imam Ibn al-Jawzi said, yes, I knew this interpretation as well. Similarly, up to 11th interpretation, Imam Ibn al-Jawzi said, yes, I knew this interpretation. But after that, Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani gave up to of a total of 40 interpretation. And Imam Ibn al-Jawzi said, I knew only the first 11 interpretation and the rest 29 interpretation I did not know. Today, I heard all the interpretation from Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. Allahu Akbar. But this is not it. When 40 interpretation have been narrated, then Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani said, Al-an narji min al-qal ila al-hal. Now we leave the interpretation of Kaal and come to the interpretation of Hal, of the present. So when the first interpretation of the present of the Hal was narrated, the whole assembly got agitated. Imam Ibn al-Jawzi, who was the Muhaddis Zamana, he tore his clothes and fell to the ground in a state of ecstasy. This was the knowledge of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. Allahu Akbar. Imam Yafi, he writes a poem, an ashar in Miratul Janal. غوث الورى غيث الندى نور الخدى بدر الدجى شمس الدوحى بل انور. Those who think we use titles from our own, Imam Yafi, who was one of the greatest Imam in the world, uses this title in his poem for Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. Similarly, Imam Ibn Rajab Al-Hanbali says in Az-Zair At-Tabaqat Al-Hanabila, he says, كَانَ أَزْهُوَ زَاهِدُ شَيْكُ السَّلِي وَقُلْوَةُ الْعَارِفِينَ وَسُلْطَانُ الْمَشَائِكَ وَالسَّيْدُ الْأَهْلِ الطَّرِيقَةِ مُحْيُدِّينَ أَبُو مُحَمَّدْ صَاحِبُ الْمُقَامَاتِ وَالْقَرَامَاتِ وَالْأُلُومِ وَالْمَعْرِفَةُ وَأَحْوَالِ الْمَشْهُورَةِ. These are just the title which he uses in his names. We have not created these things ourselves. But the glorious narrators, the glorious interpretations, the glorious Imam has been saying this for 900 years. Allahu Akbar. Imam Zahabi says in Siyari Alamin Nubala, he says, لَيْسَ فِي قِبَارِ الْمَشَائِكْ مَنْ لَهُ أَحْوَالٌ وَكَرَمَاتٌ أَكْثَرُ مِنْ شَيْخ عَبْدُ الْقَادِرِ جِيلَانِ. He said that there was no one among the great scholars and sheikhs whose miracles were greater than that of Sheikh Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala. Imam Is bin Abdus Salam, his statement which is quoted by Imam Zahabi in his book, he says, يَكُولُ مَا نُقِلَتْ إِلَيْنَا كَرَمَاتُ أَحَدٍ بِالتَّوَاتُرِ إِلَّا شَيْخ عَبْدُ الْقَادِرِ جِيلَانِ. He said, until today the miracles of any saint have not been narrated as frequently, as repeatedly as those narrated from Sheikh Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala. The miracles of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani has been said so many times that no other saint or wali is compared to him. Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Imam Abul Baqa said that he heard from Hazrat Yahya bin Najah al-Adib al-Nuh that he went to Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani's majlis, and Hazrat Yahya bin Najah was a great writer, a great poet. And he was the Imam of Grammar. He was the Imam of Nuh. He says, I wondered how many poems will Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani will recite in his speech. So I had a thread with me that whenever Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani would recite a poem, I would tie a knot on the thread. So I tied the knot to the thread and hid the thread under my clothes whenever Hazrat Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani will recite a poem. So he would hide the thread under his clothes so no one could notice. When many knots were made, Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani turned to me, and there was a crowd of around 70,000 people in this program, and he turned to me and he said, "Ana uhillu wa anta taqid." He said that I untied the knots and you are tying the knots again. When Hazrat Najah heard this, he immediately stood up and he repented. Allahu Akbar. Such was the knowledge, such was the marifat of Hazrat Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. Allahu Akbar. Imam Yafi al-Shafi says that Imam Abul Hasan Ali bin Yusuf bin Jarir al-Shafi says in Manaqib Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, he says that with five more quotations. He says that a woman came to Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani with a son, and she said, "My son is very fond of you." And this narration has also been narrated by Mullah Ali Qari as well, and by Imam Zahabi in Miratul Jalan as well. The lady says that my son is very fond of you, so I thought to leave him in your presence so that he can become become your servant and a darwish as well. She left his son with Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, and she left. When she came to visit her son after a long period of time, and his son was on his way for suluk and marifat, she found his son very thin, and saw that he was eating dry barley bread. So she came in anger, and she went to the court of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani and saw that Hazrat Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani was eating chicken. And after eating, he was collecting all the bones at one side. The mother said, "You are eating chicken and my son is eating dry barley bread." Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani told to the bones to be in your original form again. And slowly, that bone started becoming chicken again. And as soon as she saw it, Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani says that when your son will reach this level of marifat, he can eat whatever he wants. Allahu Akbar. Such was the marifat of Hazrat Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. The Khalifa Mustanjad Billah, he comes to Ghawsul Azam and offers him 20 bags of dinars of gold. Ghawsul Azam said, "Take it, I do not need it." He kept on insisting to take it. So Ghawsul Azam picked the sacks which was in the most perfect state and took it in his hand. He picked up two sacks in his hand and squeezed the sack of dinar of the gold, and as soon as he squeezed the sack, blood started dripping from the sack full of dinars. He said that, take the bags, you are a tyrant, you do not fear Allah, you suck the blood of the people, you rob their wealth and you bring it to me as a gift. Allahu Akbar. This is the wisdom of Ghawsul Azam. This is the knowledge of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. And this has been narrated by Hazrat Abul Abbas Khuzri. The blessing of guardianship comes from a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam to Siddiq Akbar, and from him to Hazrat Farooq Azam, and from him to Hazrat Usman Ghani, and from him to Hazrat Mawla Ali, and from him to Imam Hassan, and from him to Imam Hussain, and from him to Imam Zainul Abideen, and from him to Imam Muhammad Baqir, and from him to Imam Jafar al-Sadiq, and from him to Musa Qazim, and from him Ali Rasa, and from him Imam Jawad, and from him to Imam Naqi, and from him to Imam Taqi, and from him to Imam Hassan Askari, and until the 12th Imam, Imam Mahdi does not appear, this vilayat, this guardianship will be held by Ghawsul Azam. There can be no guardian in the east, west, south and north unless the seal of Ghawse Paak is affixed on him. Ghawse Paak says, "Qadami hada ala rakabatin kulli waliullah," that my foot is on the necks of all the saints of all the waliullah. A poet says these lines, "Wah kya martaba hai Ghawse bala tera, ucho ucho ke saro se kadam ala tera, sar bhala kya koi jane ke hai kaisa tera, Auliya malte hain aankhein, wo hai talwa tera." I shall end my speech here. Wa akhiru da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum.